स्टूडेंट्स, ले लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द इलेक्ट्रोड पोटेंशियल, स्टैंडर्ड इलेक्ट्रोड पोटेंशियल एंड रेफरेंस इलेक्ट्रोड्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक, दैट इज derivation of Nernst equation. To study this Nernst equation, now let us consider an electrode dipped in a solution containing its own ions. For example, let us consider a zinc rod dipped in a solution containing zinc sulfate. When a zinc is in contact with a solution containing zinc sulfate or its own ions, the following equilibrium is established. Now let us consider this equilibrium involves reduction, that is from left to right. In this reaction, the reaction from left to right or the equilibrium towards left involves reduction reaction. Zinc 2 plus ions takes up 2 electrons and reduces to zinc. How will you write the EMF? The EMF is equal to EMF of zinc electrode equal to E naught of zinc electrode minus RT by NF long activity of zinc divided by activity of zinc 2 plus. Or I can write this equation as E naught of zinc 2 plus RT by NF into ln of activity of zinc 2 plus divided by activity of zinc. Usually the activity of zinc, that is solid, is usually taken as unity. Then I can write this equation as E naught standard electrode potential of zinc electrode plus RT by NF. Okay, if I change the sign, the numerator will become denominator and denominator will become numerator, to be ln of activity of zinc 2 plus ions. Since this activity of zinc, because it is a solid, it is equal to 1. This is EMF of zinc 2 plus. This is the standard electrode potential of zinc electrode. That is, when a zinc electrode is in contact with a solution of concentration of unity, at 25 degree centigrade, the potential developed on the electrode is called standard electrode potential of zinc. Okay? When the solution is very dilute, the activity will be almost equal to concentration. Therefore, I can write this equation as plus RT by NF into ln of concentration of zinc 2 plus ions. So therefore, the EMF of the zinc electrode is directly proportional to the concentration of zinc 2 plus. I can write this equation for any electrode. For example, if I have silver electrode like this, silver solid, then this equation will becomes standard electrode potential of zinc plus RT by NF into ln of concentration of Ag plus. Likewise, we can write the equation for any electrode. Okay? Here the EMF of the silver electrode depends on the concentration of Ag plus ions with which it is in contact. I am writing a general equation. For example, if I have a general equation, I can write for any metal. Use metal solid. Depends on its valency. It takes up for n electrons and reduces to metal. In this case, I can write the equation has E M N plus M E naught M N plus M plus R T by N F into ln of concentration of M N plus. Simply I can write this for any metal. This is the general expression. See, here, what is R? R is gas constant. It is 8.314 joules per Kelvin per mole. And T is temperature. That is 25 degrees centigrade. Usually, it is converted into Kelvin. Okay? Equal to 298 Kelvin. And what is Faraday? Faraday is 96,500 coulombs per mole. Okay? When I substitute these values in this equation, standard electrode potential R is 8.314. Okay? Temperature is 298 Kelvin. Divided by N is the number of electrons transferred in electrochemical reaction. It varies with the valency of the electrode. And Faraday is 96,500 coulombs per mole. And into ln is nothing but 2.303 into log divided by that is into concentration of metal ions. This value, you know, when we simplify this, it becomes 0.05 m1. E0 plus 0.0591 divided by n into log of m n plus. Okay. This is called Nernst equation. Okay. This is the Nernst equation which is useful to find out the EMF of any electrode. Okay. Provided you must know its standard electrode potential and N is the number of electrons transferred in an electrochemical reaction. For example, in the case of zinc electrode, N is equal to 2. In the case of silver electrode, N is equal to 1. In the case of aluminium electrode, N is equal to 3. Okay? Then, on substituting the concentration of the electrolytic solution, you can easily find out EMF of any cell. So, this is known as Nernst equation. So, Nernst equation, simply I can write it as E is equal to E naught plus 0.0591 divided by N into log of concentration of metal ions. Okay, this is standard electrode potential of metal ions and this is EMF. Okay? This is called Nernst equation. You can write the Nernst equation for any given electrode. Next we are going to study what about the same convention? The sign convention means in a galvanic cell or any cell we have two electrodes, which is positive electrode, which is negative electrode. Remember, the electrode where oxidation occurs, okay, it is a negative electrode. Okay, the electrode where oxidation occurs, it is negative electrode. Where reduction occurs, it is positive electrode. So, any electrode where there will be a liberation of electrons or donation of electrons, which act as a source of electrons, that is the negative electrode. The electrode where there is absorption of electrons or gaining of electrons or where reduction occurs, that electrode is positive electrode. For example, in a galvanic cell, at zinc electrode oxidation occurs, so therefore zinc behaves as negative electrode. Whereas copper, having tendency to undergo reduction, it takes up electrons and reduces to copper. Reduction occurs, so therefore in a galvanic cell, copper is a positive electrode. And by IUPAC एमपीएससी सेल कंटेंट है, आईयूपीएससी कन्वेंशन, द रिडक्शन पोटेंशियल, द रिडक्शन पोटेंशियल इज ऑलवेज पॉजिटिव, पॉजिटिव वैल्यू. ओके, इफ एट एनी एयरपोर्ट इट इज रिडक्शन अकर्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ एनी एयरपोर्ट कनेक्टेड विथ ए स्टैंडर्ड हाइड्रोजन एयरपोर्ट, बिकॉज वी हैव स्टडीड इन द लास्ट क्लास, वी कैन नॉट फाइंड आउट द एयरपोर्ट पोटेंशियल separately, it has to be connected with some reference electrode. For example, if I have an electrode whose electrode potential is to be found out, when it is connected with the hydrogen electrode, if the electrode under examination involves reduction, then it will have reduction potential. That reduction potential EMF value will be positive. If the electrode connected to the hydrogen electrode which involves oxidation, okay, the oxidation potential is always negative value. This is the same convention given by IUPAC method. So remember, if the electrode involves oxidation, when it is connected with reference electrode, that is hydrogen electrode, then its oxidation potential will always be negative value. If any electrode behaves like a reduction electrode, that is where reduction occurs, then its reduction potential will be positive. Okay, this is about the sign convention of electrodes by IUPAC method. Okay, the next topic. Okay, you are tired BSc students. Okay, you are, this unit is ended with this topic. The remaining topics we will study in the next class.